Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, my mother spent the last year of her life in a nursing facility compassionately operated by the Sisters of St. Joseph, to whom I will be ever grateful. And while there, she made a new best friend, Ruth. And every day, my mother and Ruth would help each other down the hallway and get on the elevator and go down to the gift store. And each day they would find a new gift, a trinket, an ornament, a stuffed animal, most of which they would give away to other residents or to family members. Just check out my house. And as those gifts kept coming in, I kept thinking to myself, how big can this store be in that facility? So I had to see for myself. So one day I accompanied my mother and Ruth to the gift store, and sure enough, it was very, very small, maybe the average size of a sitting room. But yet, each day, amazingly, they were able to find a new gift in their midst. And I thought to myself, what a beautiful image, reminding us of the purpose of our lives and vocations. In the midst of the struggles and turmoil of our world and our church, and maybe even our lives, God is always present, bestowing gifts upon us to behold and to share with one another. And when we live with such recognition, we are able to repeat daily those words we just sung. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. At this Chrism Mass, where we are united as bishop and priests and deacons, consecrated religious, seminarians, young people, brothers and sisters in Christ, we are reminded of the many gifts in our midst. Having just celebrated the 90th anniversary of our diocese, we give thanks for the gift of faith and how it continues to grow so rapidly and immensely in this diocese, with again close to 3,000 young people being confirmed this year. And they certainly are a gift to us, with close to 1,500 people being received into the church at Easter. And we are so grateful to all in this diocese who teach and spread our Catholic faith. And so we must leave here today with a renewed commitment to keep our eyes fixed on Jesus, the one who inspires, the one who perfects our faith. Our Holy Father, Pope Francis, has named this the year of consecrated life. And we give thanks to the men and women religious who have served and continue to serve in our diocese. We are often told that mere words can help people to snooze. Of course, that's never the case when I'm preaching. I understand that. But our Holy Father said this year of consecrated life is given to us and to the church to wake up the world, not through mere words, but through the faithful, joyful example of those living the consecrated life and embracing so beautifully poverty and chastity and obedience. Thank you for the gift you are to us. In a special way, in our church, we are celebrating the gifts of married love and family life, especially as we prepare to welcome our Holy Father to the United States, to Philadelphia in September for the World Meeting of Families, as we prepare for the Synod that will be conducted in Rome in October, seeking new and creative ways for the church to help married couples, parents, and their children. And our Holy Father has asked us to pray for that intention, that the Synod will bear abundant fruit. And he says also to pray for holy families. He has given us a beautiful prayer. There's a holy card I'm asking all of you to take as you leave church today and to pray daily as a family. It says beautifully, Jesus and Mary and Joseph, make our families cenacles of prayers. Make our families holy like you, Mary and Joseph and Jesus. Today, in a special way, the church celebrates the gift of the priesthood. And I join all of you in thanking our priests for their faithful and generous ministry. I know, dear brothers, sometimes as we carry out our ministry, you can only see your weaknesses and limitations. But today is God's gift to you, because he asks you in all humility to see the gift that you are, the gift that your ministries are to his church and his people. Of course, knowing that all we do is only through the grace of God. Dear brothers, ordained in the very person of Jesus Christ, you will soon renew the promises you made on the day of your ordination and pledge anew in imitation of Jesus to offer yourself sacrificially to the church. Therefore, when like him, you are sometimes misunderstood or experience setbacks or unreasonable expectations, do not lose that priestly joy. Embrace them as opportunities to die to self, to grow ever closer to the Lord in holiness, so that like him, we can give of ourselves without ever counting the cost. It's never easy. So how blessed you are today with the love and prayers of the people who are with you and who are back at home in your parishes and communities. Thank you, dear brothers, for the gift you are to them and to me. At this Holy Eucharist, we celebrate the most precious gift, the gift of God's only begotten Son, perfectly revealed in word and in sacrament. In just a few moments, I will consecrate the chrism and bless the sacred oils, and they will be used to bring the saving power of Jesus to others throughout this diocese, especially those to be baptized and confirmed and ordained, and those in need of healing and strength. As representatives from our parishes and communities come forth to receive them and to bring them back home, we rejoice in knowing that it's true. The Spirit of the Lord is upon us, and we are all sent forth to bring glad tidings to the lowly and to heal the brokenhearted. If I could just return to that image I used earlier. My mother preceded Ruth in death. But just a couple weeks ago, Ruth died. And I received a note from one of the sisters at the nursing facility. And she said, "Dear Bishop, I am sure your mother was there to welcome Ruth. And I bet you the first thing she did was to take her to the gift store." But only now, the note said, those gifts are in their fullness, and pray God will be theirs. A beautiful image, reminding all of us of the purpose of our lives and vocations. As we continue this journey here on earth, we are called to help one another to see God's gifts in our midst, so that one day we will all share them in their beauty and richness and fullness, united with Mary and Joseph and their Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. To him, power and glory forever and ever.